the cost, but we're not going to invest that money into our education that has the that puts us in a position to earn more. You know, to live I think it depends on how you work it as well, right? So when we talk about exposure, right, how do we give our students a plan, a blueprint? Because if some students, it's how you make it work for you. Because I wasn't always the most fortunate, right? But now I'm blessed with so many opportunities because I work hard. And I started learning things as I was going along, like, okay, let me secure this internship here, which would give me experience in this and give me an opportunity to meet some people and learn some things that have put me in a different position. And sometimes that comes with sacrifices that some of our students may not even be able to make because they're trying to pay for they're in college. Now they're working full time, maybe at a fast food or retail just to get through college. So they don't even have the privilege of taking an internship because either it's no pay or it's little pay and they're on their own because they're independent students. So I feel like there's so many things to factor in, right? So it's like, okay, a student is passionate about their higher education and this is what they want to do, but how do we talk about, once again, getting these students through effectively and the systemic issues that go along with those things? And I feel like it's not that simplistic, even though I do understand that student debt is crazy, but I would say it's a huge investment into yourself, right? And then how do we prepare our students for scholarships that covers all of that student debt? Now they're getting a free ride. And
everybody,
you know, and
ride,
listen, everybody can't, but those opportunities are there. So for the ones that can get them, why not help them get them? Because it's there. It's there. It's how you learn certain things and make it work for you as you go along.
Definitely. I agree with you on that. But, you know, I can agree. If college is free, great. You know, excellent opportunities. Get everybody a scholarship. But when you have to take debt... When you have people taking out debt, that's a totally different story. You mentioned people investing in houses and cars, but they can't invest in their education. I'd rather invest in a house than a college degree, especially a rental property that'll pay me for the rest of my life. College degree might pay you. It's all a might. It depends on the field.
It is.
And the field that you're in may not exist in 20 years.
And I think
then
this is the same logic for housing too, though. Because what if you buy a house in an area that's not so popular?
I can sell my house. You can't sell that degree if it doesn't work out.
But listen, though, that's another thing, too. I feel like we have an idea of we have to get a degree in this to be able to navigate this field. Because there's people with education degrees that work in business in corporate America and make great money. And there's no business degree. I feel like there's not always a right degree you need to have to make X amount of money. I mean, if you're into nursing, it's kind of set, like, right? Like, that's what that is. And that's how that field operates. But once again, I feel like it's sometimes a limited notion of what's out there and what we could do with what we have. There's so much power in having a degree. It's so much power in having a degree because you can do so much. Now, does everybody have access to it? They may not. They may not. But it's like, once again, how do we create that?
Power. I get what Jermaine is saying, though, Mark, because, like, honestly...
To a job, key to networking, key to opportunity, but it's not... I wouldn't call it power.
I don't know if I necessarily agree with Jermaine on the term of power, but I think for sure I definitely agree with Jermaine on the term of leverage, because like I know like if I don't have a high school degree and I'm talking about in the sense of a job, right? So I'm not talking about entrepreneurship or starting my own business, but if I you know apply to this job where I want to be a teacher, I want to be a professional working as an advocate within this startup company or this nonprofit, the fact that I have degrees, I'll definitely at least get an interview. I'll have my foot in the door, at least get an interview. If I just start saying to them, hey, I'm looking for a job, whatever, whatnot, I volunteered at schools before, whatever, whatnot, and, I'm really good with kids. Okay, well, did you go to college? Well, no. Okay, did you go to community college? Well, no. Did you finish high school? Yes, I did, but, sorry, we're not going to talk to you right now. Like, we have other applicants that are deemed more important. So I think it does give you leverage in a sense. Like, I know for... Yeah, I would say leverage, because I know for sure that you know, if I lose a job today, or I lose a job tomorrow, or tomorrow, whatever the case may be, I know for sure that even though that job won't be maybe as lucrative or as great as the other job I had, I know for sure just because I have a degree, I should at least get a callback. Is that guaranteed? No. But I definitely think that as compared to somebody else that might, I don't know, be, you know, just straight out of high school and is trying to figure it out and go into, like, you know, associate's degree program, I don't think so. But
I should agree with that. It's definitely leverage, but how?
And I think,
because if I'm going to someone and saying, "Hey, please get me a job," I don't feel very powerful.
Mm-hmm.
Power is an ownership.
Yeah.
Power is an ownership.
True.
That's not power to say, "Hey, can I get a job? Let me, I just filled up my application." That's not power.
I think it depends. Because you could have ownership and still work on someone as well. And do both and be happy doing it.
Well, that's a different story. We're talking about an interview trying to get a job from someone. We're not talking about ownership.
True. I mean, but so you have a master's degree, right?
Absolutely not.
But you have bachelor's?
I have 0 degree, brother.
Okay, and you have home ownership. That's cool. So what I would say is, from my experience, one thing I know is that, so for example, at my job right now, I know that if I decide to, there's so many opportunities out there for me because I have a degree and I'm currently enrolled in a master's program. So there's definitely a lot of leverage in that. It's a lot of comfort in that. And it's power to have the, and it's a privilege. Like I said, I've been blessed, but it's a privilege to know that if I want to pack up and go because my level of education, I can do that anytime that I want. Is it going to be easy? No, but I'm going to make it happen because I have the means to make it happen, especially in this day and age that we live in today.
I can 100% agree with that. I can agree with that, 100%.
So when I say it's power, that's exactly what I mean.
Okay.
And when we talk about the power, right? So we can talk about how a lot of the home ownership, but first-time home ownership programs are getting cut by people who have degrees that's in these positions making these decisions. That's power. And my degree, but that's real. That's real, though.
Is the degree doing that, or is the person in the position?
Yes, but the degree is the bare minimum requirement.
Trust me, brother. People in those positions, they don't get in because of their degree. They get in because of their network.
That's true.
They get in because of their family connection.
Of course. I wouldn't say it.
A lot of people have degrees. I know someone that works at Macy's with a degree. Where's the power?
Of course. And once again, coming out of college, like you said, it doesn't guarantee you get a job, right? It's how you make it work for you. You gotta hustle. Nothing is gonna be given.